Monarch represents the last of the California grizzlies. It's a pretty sad history. It's estimated that there were about 10,000 grizzlies before the gold rush, and then within 100 years, settlers drive them to extinction. The discovery of gold attracted a large population to settle here in California, but in order to do so, they had to clear the land of local animals, fauna, and people. The gold rush was devastating to the indigenous people that were living here. Native American populations in California plunged from about 150,000 people to less than 30,000. The story of Monarch is a story of settler colonialism. It very much mirrors the story of indigenous people in California. Monarch was captured in 1889. It was part of a publicity stunt to capture the last California grizzly, which was commissioned by William Randolph Hearst, who was the editor of the San Francisco Examiner. He hired Alan Kelly, who spends about 5 months looking for a California grizzly and is unsuccessful. And then he hears of one that's trapped and he goes and purchases it in Southern California. And then after that, Monarch is brought to San Francisco. He's initially put on display at Woodward Gardens, which is this private, like, amusement park zoo that was in the Mission District. Then Monarch was put on display as part of the California Midwinter International Exposition in 1894. After that, he's put on display at Golden Gate Park, which ends up being his last home. It is a cage. People can go right up to the enclosure and even throw food. After Monarch's death in 1911, he was taxidermied and then put on display at the Memorial Museum, which is now the De Young. He also then comes to the Academy in the 1950s and then becomes part of our sort of more permanent display here. I have complicated feelings about Monarch being on display, but I think he can be a powerful teaching tool as one of the last California grizzlies. He can connect us to a species long gone and make us think about how we can protect the ones that are still here. By reflecting on the past, we can think more about human-wildlife relationships and how we can make them better.